Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
Working with text in PowerPoint is easy. It's similar to working in a word processing program like Microsoft Word, so the experience should be pretty familiar to you. All you have to do is insert a text box or click an existing placeholder, and your cursor will appear inside. Now you can type anything you want. You can use the space bar on your keyboard to add spaces, and if you want to start a new line, just press Enter. If you make a mistake like I did, that's okay. You can press Backspace or Delete to fix it. You can also use your keyboard's arrow keys to move the insertion point left, right, up, or down. This is useful if you only need to move a few spaces or lines at a time, but you can also jump over entire words at a time. Hold the Control key and press the left or right arrow keys to jump over one word at a time. There may come a time when you need to work with text in your presentation, maybe to copy and paste it or to move it to a different location. To do that, you need to know how to select text first. Just click and drag your mouse over the text, then let go. See how it's highlighted gray? That means the text is selected. To select all of the text on an entire slide, go to the Select command on the Home tab and choose Select All. Pressing the Control key and A key on your keyboard at the same time will also select all the text. Now that we know how to select text, let's try copy and paste. Just click the Copy command on the ribbon, choose where you want the text to go, then click Paste. You can also get to these commands by right-clicking on the slide. For example, to cut and paste, start by selecting your text, then right-click, and choose Cut. The original text will disappear, and now we can paste it anywhere we want by right-clicking again. If you want to move a selection of text from one place to another, you can use the drag and drop method. First, select the text you want to move. Now click and drag where you want it to go. If you make a mistake or change your mind, you can use the undo button on the toolbar to undo the last action. To the right is the redo button. This allows you to reverse the last undo. Next, I'd like to take a look at formatting options like font color, size, and alignment, all of which can have a big effect on your presentation. To format text in PowerPoint, you can select just the text you want, or you can select an entire text box and format everything inside at once. You might want to start with the options in the font group, where you'll find lots of different features that you can play around with. In this example, I'm going to choose a different font color, a different font, and a slightly bigger size. I'm also going to format the text in italics. See what a difference all these changes can make? If you want to change the placement or alignment of your text, take a look at the commands in the paragraph group. Your options include left, center, right, and justified, which can be used to align paragraphs. I think centered looks best. Also in this group, you can change the vertical alignment, the text direction, or add or remove bullets from your text box. These are all great ways to customize your text, so your slide looks exactly the way you want. Now you know the basics, including cut, copy, and paste, undo and redo, and even some formatting techniques. That should be everything you need to know to work with text in PowerPoint.